This is Math 99, 12.1, and this is the second part of the lecture for 12.1. We're going to keep talking about exponential growth, but we're going to get at two things, different types of graphing, as well as compound interest. And these are both exponential growth topics. And the little thing I want to add to graphing is if I had something like y equals 2 to the x plus 1. So notice we know what this looks like, y equals 2 to the x. So before I flip over to Desmos, I want you to think about what does adding this one inside the function do? What would that do to that function? What would that do to a parabola? What would that do to a square root? So there's y equals 2 to the x. So now if I have y equals 2 to the interesting. It looks like it shifts it up one from here, but it doesn't. It doesn't shift it up one here. What it is doing is it's moving it to the left one. So this point on the original equation, 0, 1, it shifted back one to the point negative 1, 1. And you can see it here too. This point 1, 2, that is a point on the original, it gets shifted back one, so it's 0, 2. It shifted to the left one. So this in here is going to move it left, right. So if I had to graph something like y equals 3 to the x, I know that this is usually goes to the point 0, 1 to x plus 2. If I had to graph that, this usually goes through x plus 1, but if I have this, this is going to move it left 2. So now it's going to go through the point negative 2, 1. So it's now here, and then it still goes over 1, up 3, right? It's still going to triple in its growth. So things like this are just going to move it left and right. Now let's talk about compound interest. Interest that compounds, you know, that's any time you hear about, like, I have a 20% interest rate on my credit card, or you know, I bought my home at 2.5% or something like that. So let's just do like simple interest first, and this is, I'm just going to do this so that we can build off of it. Let's say you borrow $1,000 and it's at 5%, and every year you have to pay 5% on the loan. So when it starts, I'll say this is year, and this is the amount that you owed. So the start of the first year, you owe $1,000. So the second year, you're going to have to, if you haven't made any payments on it, I keep saying you, someone, if someone borrowed $1,000, you're going to have to pay 5% on it. So we can take 5% of the 1,000. And then we would add it back on to the 1,000. So if I go 5% of 1,000, I know that you could probably just do that. I'm going to use the calculator just to get you seeing the calculator use. 0.05 times 1,000 is 50. Now, if I just use that 50, I'm actually not taking care of everything that I owe. The 50 is just the interest. So it's actually $1,000 plus $50 more. So it's $1,050 at the first year. And notice if I do it again for another year, I just let it sit there and owe that money again. Now I could go like $1,050. I have to go 5% of that. So 0.05 times $1,050. Is $5,250. The amount that I owed increased even more. What's happening is I'm having to pay interest on the interest. In other words, I have to pay the $50 on the original $1,000, but I also have to pay $250 on the next $50 that's out there. So then I would have to add that in, and that would make it that. And I keep going, you know, I could just keep going and watch it grow. Now, one thing that's going on here is notice in order to get this, what I did was $1,000 plus this 50, which was 0.05 times $1,000. So I took 5% of $1,000 and I added it to $1,000, which is 100% of $1,000, right? Like 100% is the decimal one. So I could also think of just this jump. Instead of doing these parts individually, I could just say I have to pay 105% of what I owed, because I have to pay the 100%, and the 5% is the interest. So this growth, I could think of this instead of doing it a piece at a time like I was doing, I could do it all in one just big calculation, just times 105% each time, 1.05 over and over and over. So what's interesting to me is this is repeated multiplication. So this repeated multiplication, this is exponential growth. So, like, in order to get to this fourth one right here, notice I would have taken $1,000 because that's what I start with. I would multiply by 1.05 four times. I can write that this way, but I don't know why I would do that other than that I like writing. Times that four times is the same as it to the fourth power. So I basically have now a formula for simple interest, which is the amount that I start with, which is called the principal. We'll let P stand for it. So whatever amount I have, the principal, I'm going to multiply it by one plus what my rate is. And my rate is as a decimal. And that's then taken to the power of the time, the years. And that gives me my amount. So that's simple compounding. It's still compounding, but it's simple. This is not how compounding actually works. What is done is if money is owed, you might have heard something like it's going to be compounded at 5%, but it's going to be compounded monthly, something like that. So if it's compounded monthly, that means it's going to be compounded 12 times in the year. What we had at first simple, this was compounded annually, right? It sat there for a year, and then once that year was up, then all of a sudden it had this big jump of 5%. So when they compound it more often than annually, what they'll do is, if it's compounded 12 times in a year, they're not going to charge 5% each time they compound it. It would grow too fast. What they do is they take a 12th of the 5%. So this is going to look like this: 1,000, 1 plus that rate, but they divide the rate by 12. So you actually get like a much smaller rate, but it gets done 12 times in a year. This is kind of interesting. So this is compounded monthly, 5%. And we had this simple one, right? 1,000 times 1 plus 0.05 to the t. So let's compare these two and see what happens. So let's just make this sit there for 15 years and see what happens. So t is now 15. So I'm going to compare these two. I'm going to calculate them both and see how different they are. So that first one was 1,000 times 1 plus 5%, 0.05, and that's to the power of 15. So I noticed the first one is worth $2,078.93. Okay, so now we'll do the one where it's compounded monthly. So in order to enter that in my calculator, I'm going to go 1,000, and then again, 1 plus the 0.05. But remember that percent, it gets split into 12ths. So they're paying a 12th of the rate. But it's happening 12 times for 15 years. So after the exponent here, make sure that you use parentheses for the 12 times 15. Because then it takes it to the power of both of them multiplied together. And notice it's a bit bigger.
Which is a little counterintuitive, I think. So this one was 2078 93. Oh, whoops. This one was 2078 93. And this one was 2113 71. So just compounding it that 12 times made it grow faster. It's interesting, even though it's a 12th of the rate, it happens so many more times that it grows faster. So this is compounding monthly, compounding annually, whatever. The way that it changes our simple compounding formula, notice it takes the rate the number of compoundings, and then it multiplies the time by the number of compoundings. So number of compoundings. So this could be the number of compoundings could be pretty much any number we want. I'm going to erase. And let's do another example. Let's say that $5,000 is invested somewhere at 3.2%. And it's going to be compounded quarterly. And it's going to be left there for 17 years. We want to know how much it's going to be worth after the 17 years. So let's set it up. We can just use this relationship. The amount is the principal, 5,000, and it's 100%. Plus the rate, 3.2% is 0.032 as a decimal. If you write 0.32, you're getting 32% return, which is amazing. 0.032. So 0.032. If it's compounded quarterly, that means it's going to be compounded four times a year. So that rate gets divided by four, but it happens four times every year for 17 years. So I'm going to put that into my calculator. 5,000, 1% plus the 0.032. And again, that's going to happen four times a year for 17 years. So it looks like that will have gained a good chunk of money. 8595.7 80 cents. So that would end up being worth, it looks like, $8,595.80. So again, we can if it wasn't compounded quarterly, let's say we compounded it, we could compound it daily, every day. And let's assume there's 365 days in a year. Notice how that changes this equation. Instead of dividing by four and multiplying by four up there, we divide it by 365, so it gets a pretty small rate, but it does it a bunch of times. 365 times 17. Let me see what that ends up being. So that means this would be a 365, and this also would be a 365. A bit more, $8,614.22. So we can make this grow faster and faster by increasing the number of times it compounds, but it starts to slow down. Like that wasn't that big of a jump, really. So what happens is we can get this bigger and bigger, and with like micro trading or computers being able to calculate it really fast, you could have it compound like 1,000 times a year or something like that, or a million times a year. But what happens as this increases substantially, this number starts to slow down. And what you can do is actually get this number so big that essentially instead of compounding like in these little chunks, it's compounding continuously. And that's the fastest we can make it grow in this rate. So it's called continuous compounding. And continuous compounding has actually a simpler equation than this. It's A equals, I call it the PERT, P times e to the power of the rate times the time. So this is still the principal. This is still the rate. This is still the time. But e is actually just a number. It's a number like pi, in the sense that it's transcendental. It can't be expressed as a fraction. You know, it's irrational. And so I'm going to peek back at that calculator. And I'm going to look here, and I notice that I have e like above the division sign. So if I hit second and then that button, that's e. And notice e is about 2.7, almost 3. This is just the number. But it's the number that's, one way to think about e is it's the fastest we can make this compounding grow. It's continuous compounding. It's actually the rate that, for example, if you had a population that was growing unchecked, it didn't have predators and had ideal food conditions, e is going to be the rate that it grows at. And if I look at graphing e, you know, there's y equals 2 to the x, there's y equals 3 to the x. Since e is 2.7, it should be right between those. And it is, it's right there, you know, closer to 3 to the x and then to 2 to the x. But e is just a number, still goes through 0, 1, that whole deal. So that being said, let's take a peek at this $5,000 at 3.2%. I want the same situation, but I want to have it compound continuously instead of by some amount. So if I want to calculate this for compounding continuously, I have my principal, and then it's times e to the power of the rate. The rate is 0.032, and let's do 17 years again. Times 17. So this is how I would do this on my calculator. 5,000. And then I'm going to go e to the power of 0.032 times 17. And notice I get that 8614, 0.42. That's only about 20 cents more than what I had when I compounded it daily. But it is still more. But that's the most I can squeeze out of it. That's the fastest I can make it grow given these types of conditions. Let's see, that was 8614.42. So in the book, you're going to get asked some questions like this. A certain amount of money invested at a certain rate. And then it'll have a couple sections like, and we'll leave it in there for some amount of time. And then you'll have questions like, what if it's compounded monthly? And then maybe another one, and then compounded continuously. And so really what you're doing is you're plugging them into these formulas and then evaluating them. So this one, the amount would be 2,500, 1 plus the rate, 0.057. divided by the number of compoundings, monthly would be 12, to the power of the number of compoundings times how long it's been there. Or if it's compounded continuously, the amount would be the principal, and then times e to the power of the time, 12, times the rate, 0.057. And then you just evaluate them. You know, put them in your calculator and evaluate them. So give these some good practice. Make sure you know how to use these formulas.